Very good morning to all. Welcome back to the second part of the lecture on X-ray film. In this lecture, we'll be discussing about the X-ray film accessories and about the processing of the radiograph. We will deal under the following headings. First is film holding instruments, then a brief about the latent image, then composition and action of the processing solution, then what is manual processing and different steps involved in the manual processing, then automatic processing, and thus I'll be concluding my topic. So once we finish this lecture, we should be able to answer what is a film holding instrument, what is latent image, different composition and action of the processing solutions, steps involved in the manual processing, and what is a automatic processing. Coming to the film holding instrument, first is the RIN XCP instrument. It is used in case of the paralleling technique. As you can see in the picture, it comes in different colors. Blue color is used for anterior periapical, yellow color is used for posterior periapical, red is used for bitwing radiography, and green color is used for the endodontic purposes. Then we have RIN snap array instrument. As you can see in this picture, it is used in case of the bisecting technique. In this picture, it shows the arrangement of the film for the posterior positioning, and here we have the film arrangement for the anterior positioning. Coming to latent image, X-ray film constitutes of silver and bromide ions and free interstitial silver ions and sulfur compounds. Sulfur compound bind to the surface of silver and bromine crystals and create sensitive sites which trap the electrons. As you can see in this picture, we have the arrangement of bromine and silver ions, and we also have free silver ion in between, and we have sulfur compounds which form the sensitive sites. During irradiation, X-ray photons interact with the bromide ions, resulting in removal of the electron from the bromide ions. The free electron move to the sensitive site and impart the negative charge to the site. As you can see in this picture, once the photon interacts with the bromine atom, an electron is ejected. This electron goes to the sensitive site and thus imparts the negative charge to this sensitive site. This negatively charged sensitive site attracts the positively charged free interstitial silver ions. And when silver ions reaches negatively charged sensitive site, it is reduced to the neutral atom or the metallic silver. As you can see here, this is a negative charge imparted here by the electrons, by the trapped electrons. So because of this is negatively charged, and here we have the positive charged silver ions, so this gets attracted towards this site, and it gets converted into the neutral silver atom. As you can see here, the positive silver ion has converted into the neutral silver atom by combining with one electron. So sites containing these neutral silver atoms are called latent image sites, and overall distribution of these latent image sites in a film after exposure is called as the latent image. So we can see in this picture here, this is the arrangement of crystals before exposure. And this is the film with the crystals, and we can see the black dots here. The black dot signifies the crystals which are being exposed by the X-rays, and there is deposition of this free neutral silver atom. Then the next step is the processing. In that, first we'll discuss about the developing solution and the fixing solution. Developing solution consists of the four main components. First is developer. In developer, we have pinidone as the first electron donor, and then we have hydroquinone as the second electron donor. Then we have activator, sodium or potassium bromide. It maintains the alkaline pH of the solution, that is pH of 10, in which the activator is, developer is active. Then we have preservative. In this, we have sodium sulfite as the constituent. It protects the developer from oxidation and extends the life of the developer. Then we have restrainer. That is potassium bromide. It restrains the development of the unexposed silver halide crystals. In developing process, the exposed silver ions is reduced to the metallic silver grains. And to produce a diagnostic image, reduction process is restricted to the crystals containing latent image sites because the neutral silver atoms act as a catalyst. Thus, areas with exposed crystals appear black or radiolucent because of their higher concentration of black metallic silver, and which is not exposed, they appear as white. For example, you can see here, this is the emulsion, filled with the emulsion here. And we have here we have the crystals which is exposed with the X-rays, and these are the where we don't see any dots. Those are unexposed crystals. And here after development, we can see here the crystals which are exposed where we have the neutral silver atom. Only those crystals are being developed by the developing solution, because the neutral silver atom which was formed earlier, that is acting as a catalyst, and only those areas are being developed. Then is the role of fixing solution. Again, fixing solution consists of four main components. First is clearing agent. Clearing agent is ammonium thiosulfate. It dissolves the unexposed silver halide crystals. Then is the acidifier, that is the acetic acid, which maintains the pH of 4 to 4.5. It promotes the good diffusion of thiosulfate into emulsion, and also it helps in the proper action of the fixing solution. Then is preservative, ammonium sulfite. It prevents the oxidation of the ammonium thiosulfate or the fixing agent. Thus improves the life of the fixing agent. Then you have hardener, called as aluminium sulfate. It prevents the damage to gelatin and reduces the swelling of the emulsion after final wash and shortens the drying time. So this we can see here, this is the base and with the emulsion here. And here we have the crystals which is exposed but not developed yet. This is the latent image site, latent image. This is after development, the crystals which were exposed, those are being developed. And here after fixing, the crystals which were unexposed, those are being washed away. Thus we can see the clear image of the any object. So then comes the, then we'll discuss about the dark room equipment. In dark room, the size should be 4 into 5 feet for a single person. It should be light proof, and it should have the well-tight doors at right angles. This should be, it should be well ventilated, of temperature should not exceed more than 90 degrees Fahrenheit. And it should have a safe lighting of 15 watt bulb with GVX2 filter. You can see here in this picture, there is a GVX2 filter showing you the safe light. And this is the working area, and the safe light should be 4 feet away from the working area. Film handling area should be 4 feet away from the safe light, as I told earlier. Film handling time under the safe light should not exceed more than 5 minutes. This is the darkroom setup for the processing. We can see here, we have the provision for the hot and cold water. We are developing a solution here, fixing solution. Then we have the hangers here. Then we have the timer. This is a safe light. And this is the viewing area. We also have the exhaust here to maintain the temperature. Coming to processing techniques, there are three main techniques: manual processing, semi-automatic, and automatic. In manual, we have two methods: time temperature method and visual method. Coming to the steps in manual processing, there are 8 steps. First is replenish the solution, that is fresh developer and fixer are added daily at a rate of 8 ounces per gallon. Then next step is to stir the solution. It is done to mix the chemicals well and to equalize the temperature. Third step is to mount the film on the hanger. Fourth is to set the timer. That is for every, we can see here, for 68 degree Fahrenheit, the developing time is set at 5 minutes. And for every 2 degree increase in temperature, the developing time is reduced by 30 minutes. The fifth step is to develop. And while developing, once we immerse the film in the solution, we should agitate the film to sweep away any air bubbles. Then sixth step is to rinse. We rinse the developer solution away so that it should not get mixed with the fixing solution. We rinse for 30 seconds. Then we fix for 2 to 4 minutes. Then eighth step is to wash and dry for 10 minutes. So these were the 8 steps involved in the manual processing. Next is automatic film processing. It consists of an inline arrangement of transport mechanism driven by the motor. Transport system picks up the unwrapped film and pass it through the processing, washing and drying sections. As you can see here, this is a picture showing the automatic film processing machine. Here it shows the series of rollers that works, and film, this is the entrance of the film. It goes into developing solution, fixing solution, then comes out to this exit after drying. So to conclude, We as a stomatologist are our own clinician and radiologist as well. Thus, we should be well acquainted with the composition, types of X-ray film, and the techniques of processing radiographs. So we should be able to answer these questions. Write short note on the latent image. Describe the composition and action of the processing solution. Describe steps in manual processing. And write short note on the automatic processing. So I hope this lecture was useful. Thank you for your hearing.